Hi there, it's Marlene Hielema. This video tutorial is going to compare two different white balance tools. The white balance gray card, which you know I'm a big fan of, and one of these through the lens tools to get custom white balance in camera. Now this particular tool, how you use it is you attach it on the front of your lens and you point it at the light source. So if you are shooting on a sunny day, the light source is the sun and you point it at the sun. If you're indoors and using available light in the room, you point it at the light source. Maybe it's a lamp or something like that. In the studio, you'll also have light sources. And this particular tool, you put it where your subject is. So if I was being photographed, you would put this by my face and you would click on that and then apply that setting to all the rest of your photos taken under the same lighting conditions. Let's now compare some images taken with both methods and see which ones we like best. We used this photo to set the custom white balance in camera. When the custom white balance was set, you can see that it produced a white balance of 4150 plus 4 after that preset was loaded in camera. Okay, so that's an in-camera white balance correction. To me, it looks a little on the blue side, but let's have a comparison look at what happened with the gray card. So here's the photo of our gray card. So 4150 plus 4 is what the in-camera reading said, and if I use my gray card, 4350 plus 8. Honestly, that's very close in color temperature. If you have only 200 degrees difference between these two methods, it's pretty darn close. Okay, so let's compare these photos side by side. And I've used the same photo just to keep us comparing apples to apples, oranges to oranges. The one on the left here was taken using the through the lens custom white balance. And the one on the right was white balanced according to the gray card. And the values are very, very similar. In this case, it doesn't make a lot of difference to the image color. I can see a little bit of difference in this area here in the snow. It looks a little warmer here because this temperature was 200 degrees warmer and it had a little extra magenta added in. So this was 200 more points of yellow than this one on the left. Both of them are usable. However, as I mentioned, they're both neutral, and maybe I don't want neutral. Maybe I think they both could use a little warm-up. What it does demonstrate, though, is that the color is very close using both of these methods. And this is a conclusion that I wasn't expecting to find.
Wow, I must admit, I was quite surprised by the similarity of using both these methods of creating custom white balance, whether you're using the in-camera method or whether you're doing it in editing. I think that if you want to do minimal editing of your photos, perhaps you shoot JPEGs, this is probably your best bet. If you shoot RAW files, this is going to work just fine. This is also really great for video. In fact, I balanced this video here using this little disc. So there's several of these on the market. This happens to be a ProMaster no-name brand, and there's also something called an Expo disc, which works exactly the same way. Well, I hope you enjoyed my tutorial and my comparison. If you have done this test yourself, or if you have any other things to tell me about, I'd love to hear about them. Just leave your comments right below the video. And if you like this video, tell your friends, give me a thumbs up on YouTube. Thanks for watching. It's Marlene from Image Maven.